27-year-old Jessica Ai is one of the best in women's mixed martial arts.
Round number one. Quick start from Frosto.
Oh, good right hand. She's dropped it. Ai looking to finish.
She's ranked number 9th in the world for pound-to-pound and best fighter and is poised to make her debut in the UFC.
Bellator is that mid-level organization that is like a step ahead of the NWFS, which you guys are familiar with, and UFC is the top level. So if you can make it there, then you've obviously proven yourself to be an amazing athlete to be able to make it to that level.
How in the world did you get into fighting?
One time in high school when I was playing soccer, it was my senior year, and I remember one of the goalie came out and ran to get the ball, and we both collided, and she fell over and just literally, like, I mean, they had to stop the game. Like, she had the wind taken out, and I was just kind of standing there like, are you okay? Like, it didn't hurt me, you know what I mean? And I was the one going after the ball. Like, she ran into me and just fell over. So I felt like then I started realizing, like, man, I'm kind of tough. And then when I came here to Strong Style when I was 19, and I remember one of the guys, you know, threw a hard punch at me, and I was just like, all right, come on, is that all you got? You know, so it was like, I was able to keep pushing past it, and I was like, oh my God, I'm a lot tougher than I think. And plus, I didn't want to embarrass myself. Like, I wanted them to know that, like, I wasn't just some pretty girl trying to come into the gym. That was tough.
So are you out of the ring a girly girl, or is that still a work in progress?
It's still a work in progress. It's actually, after I had fought Zoila, which was one of my biggest fights to date so far, all of my female friends had a bet with me. They're like, Jessica, if you win for the next year, you have to carry a purse. So I've been carrying a purse now for a year, and like I bought like one from Guess. Like, I've been looking at like a Coach one. Like, after my fight, like, I was like, I'm gonna buy myself a really, really pretty Coach purse or something like that. So it's fun.
For this knockout, the road hasn't been easy.
So it was back in 2003, my car broke down and I called my father to help me. And while we were working on the car, a drunk driver hit us on the side of the road. It was, you know, it was a devastating struggle. I had a broken back, tons of minor injuries, a broken foot. I was never able to play basketball the same because of my back injury, and the where my back injury was, it's thoracic. Any type of thoracic breaks can actually cause paraplegic, quadriplegic. So I was on that fine line of, you know, being a quadriplegic or paraplegic.
So how do you think that that's changed you as a fighter?
I have this confidence that I'll never feel like I'm enabled ever again. I can't be enabled because my mind is so strong, so I can always push past it.
Her nickname may be the Evil Eye, but outside the ring, it's all about the love of her hometown.
I am from Northeastern Ohio. I moved to Cleveland to train back when I was 19, but I'm originally from a little small town called Rootstown. And I, you know, I'm actually going back there to do some work with them and to kind of help promote and, you know, let these young kids know that, like, it doesn't matter what kind of school you're from. It doesn't matter if you're from, you know, a place where there's only 100 students. So you're able to, if you believe in yourself, you're able to move forward. I love that I'm able to represent Cleveland. Like, I feel like they're able to have that person or that athlete that they can truly look up that will never leave their city, that will always be here to promote them, to give them light, to know that, oh man, I can go to Cleveland and maybe there's a possibility I'll see Jessica Ai because she's always there, you know? And I want to be able to be that superhero for us.